I am Narasimha Rao, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Government Degree College for Women, Khammam. Today, we are going to discuss about the continuation of sequences. We have already lectured one lesson about sequence. In that sequence, we learned the main four concepts, that is sequence, limit of sequence, convergent sequence and divergent sequence. So what is sequence? We recall once again the previous concepts. So the sequence is, a sequence is a function whose domain is set of positive integers. So what is the limit of sequence? The limit of sequence is, the limit of sequence is a real number to which the value of Sn are close for large values of n. The limit of sequence is the real number to which the value of Sn are closed for large values of n. What is a convergent sequence? So a sequence is said to be a convergent sequence if for each epsilon greater than 0 there exists a number n such that small n greater than capital N, it implies mod Sn minus L less than epsilon. So this is convergent sequence. Convergent means a sequence has a finite limit. If it has finite limit, then that sequence is said to be a convergent sequence. A sequence has does not have finite limit, then those type of sequence we are called as divergent sequence. Now today we are going to discuss about the continuation of sequences. Here, according to continuation of previous class, a sequence Sn is said to be a convergent sequence if for each epsilon greater than 0 there exists capital N such that small n greater than capital N, this implies mod Sn minus S less than epsilon. Now here, what about n? Here n depends on epsilon only, and also n will have to be a large. Suppose if n is very large, if epsilon will become small. And take the one example regarding convergent sequence. Example 1, Sn is equal to 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4. Check the sequence is convergent or divergent. What is given sequence? The given sequence is Sn is equal to 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4. Now limit of Sn is equal to limit n tends to infinity 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4. Now take the n common from numerator and denominator. So nn gets cancelled. So n common means 3 plus 1 by n by 7 minus 4 by n. Now apply limit. Limit n tends to infinity means 1 by n tends to 0. That means 3 plus 0 by 7 minus 0, this is equal to 3 by 7. Now the limit of Sn is 3 by 7 means that the limit Sn has finite limit. If the sequence has finite limit, then that sequence is said to be a convergent sequence. therefore Sn has finite limit and Sn is converges to what? 3/7. So now here we observe epsilon value and n value. For each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a number n such that n greater than capital N, this implies mod 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4 minus 3/7 less than epsilon. Here, according to definition of convergent sequence, each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a number capital N such that N is greater than capital N, that is, that implies mod Sn minus S. That means here Sn means mod of 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4 and S means here 3/7. So according to this one, here suppose take the example n is equal to, for value of n is equal to, the Sn will becomes 0.7000 and mod Sn minus S will becomes approximately 0.2714. And take the another value, n is equal to 3, and for if substitute n is equal to 3 in Sn, Sn will becomes 0.5882 and mod Sn minus L, Sn minus S will becomes 0.1597. In similar way, we take the all values. For large values of n, suppose you take the large value approximately n is equal to 400, n is equal to 400, that means here Sn will becomes Sn 0.4285, and mod Sn minus S 0.0010. So for large values of n, Sn will becomes closer to closer zero values. Okay, so large values of n, Sn closest for zero or some finite value. So here Sn is equal to 3n plus 1 by 7n minus 4 is got some finite value, so Sn is converges to 3/7. Now we take the another example. The sequence 1 by n square is convergent because limit of 1 by n square is 0. For large values of n, 1 by n square, what is the value of 1 by n square? It will become 0. Therefore, here 0 is the finite value. So the sequence got some finite value. So therefore, this is a convergent sequence. Third example. The sequence an is equal to minus 1 whole power n is not a convergent because it has two finite values. That means for large values of n, suppose if n is even, the sequence Sn equals to the 1. If n is odd, the sequence Sn equal to the minus 1. So there is no particular value for finite value. So therefore, here Sn, the sequence An is equal to minus 1 whole power n is not convergent. Another example, we take the another example. Suppose nth root n is converges to 1 by Cauchy test or general convergent test. This is nth root n converges to 1. And if bn, we take another example, suppose bn is equal to 1 plus 1 by n whole power n, then the sequence bn converges to e. Limit n tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by n whole power n becomes e. So e is a some finite value. Therefore, the sequence bn has some finite value. So bn is converges to some e value. Now, the sequence cos n pi by 3, n pi by 3 cos n pi by 3 also not convergent because there is no single finite value. Cos n pi by 3 also not convergent. Here we observe one theorem. This is very very important theorem for examination point of view. A sequence, the statement of the theorem, a sequence converges to an unique limit. A sequence converges to an unique limit. So according to this statement, we are proving this this theorem. Now what is the theorem? A sequence converges to a unique limit. That means any sequence has converges to only one finite limit only. If it has more than limits, those sequences are called as divergent sequences or not convergent sequences. So here, the according to this theorem, we have to prove that the given sequence has only one limit only, one and only one limit. Here we are consider to prove this theorem. We are consider, if possible, suppose that limit of Sn is equal to S and limit of Sn is equal to T. This is the our assumption. To prove the above theorem, we are consider the given theorem can be assuming that to prove the above theorem, we are consider, if possible, suppose that limit Sn is equal to S and limit Sn is equal to T. Consider epsilon greater than 0. Suppose epsilon is greater than 0. If epsilon is greater than 0, then what about epsilon by 2? Epsilon by 2 also greater than 0. So since limit Sn is equal to S, then according to definition of convergent sequence, limit Sn is equal to S. Limit Sn is equal to S means Sn is converges to S. So that means according to convergent definition, we can write it as, then there exists a number capital N such that N greater than capital N1. This implies mod Sn minus S less than epsilon by 2. This is the, we can write it as according to definition of convergent sequence. Here limit Sn is equal to S. This is our assumption. Limit Sn is equal to S means Sn is converges to S. So according to convergent definition, you can write it as there exists a number capital N1 such that N greater than capital N. This implies mod Sn minus S less than epsilon by 2. We are called this equation is 1. Since, and also we are considering limit Sn is equal to T. Sn is equal to, limit Sn is equal to T means Sn is converges to T only. Sn is converges to T means according to convergent definition, then there exists a number N2, capital N2, such that N greater than capital N2. This implies mod Sn minus T less than epsilon by 2. We are called, this is equation 2. Let here from 1 and 2, equation 1 and 2, we need to find what is the maximum of N1 and 2. To find the N1 and 2, maximum of N1 and 2, that is written as let capital N is equal to maximum of N1 and 2. For N greater than, small n greater than capital N, we must have N greater than N1 and N greater than capital N2. Therefore, for N greater than capital N, mod of S minus T, we are considered mod of S minus T we are taking. Mod of S minus T can be written as mod of S minus Sn plus Sn minus T. Here, if we observe this statement of mod, How can we write it as? Here only we can take it as mod of s minus t. Here we are adding minus sn plus sn. The mod can be written as mod of s minus t can be written as mod of s minus sn plus sn minus t. What we have did here only we are adding and subtracted by sn only. So here less than, and also we are separating the this mod, that is written as s minus sn plus mod of s minus st. Separating the mod means we can divide the two, one mod can be divided into two equal mod, two mods only. This is written as equal, can be written as mod of a plus b is written as mod of a plus b is less than or equal to mod a plus mod b. In similar way, we can write it as mod of s minus sn plus sn minus t is written as less than or equal to mod s minus sn plus mod of sn minus t. So, and also less than as less than mod sn minus s plus mod sn minus t. So, s minus sn in mod s minus sn can be written as mod of s minus s. There is no change in sign. So here less than, and what is the value of sn minus s and sn minus t according to equation 1 and 2? According to equation 1, mod of sn minus s is less than epsilon by 2, and according to equation 2, mod of sn minus t is less than epsilon by 2. Substituting these values in this equation, here mod of sn minus s is epsilon by 2 and mod of sn minus t also epsilon by 2. So epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2, what? Epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2 is equal to epsilon. Therefore, mod of s minus t is less than epsilon. Therefore, the mod of s minus t is less than epsilon for every epsilon greater than 0. So here it follows that mod of s minus t, what? Mod of s minus t is equal to 0. And hence s is equal to t only. This is the proof of the above theorem. Now take the another example. Write out the first five terms of the following sequences. This is very easiest example in this chapter. Sn is equal to 1 by 3n plus 1. First five terms means if you take n is equal to 1, s1 is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1, 1 by 4, and s2 is equal to n is equal to 2 means s2 is equal to 1 by 3 to the 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 1 by 7, and so on like this. You can find out like this one. And also second example is also 3n plus 1 by 4n minus 1. This is very easy way to find the first five terms of the this example. And also cn is equal to n by 3 power n. This is also very easy to find out the first five terms of the this example. And what about to dn? Dn is equal to sin n pi by 4. And this is also very easy way, but I will explain about this problem. And solution of d, let the given sequence is dn is equal to sin n pi by 4. For n is equal to 1, d1 is equal to sin pi by 4. That is, what is the value of sin pi by 4? Sin pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. Put n is equal to, and d2 is equal to sin 2 pi by 4. That is equal to sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2 means sin 90. Sin 90 is equal to 1. Put n is equal to 3, and d3 is equal to sin 3 pi by 4. And this is also equal to, this is also written as sin 3 by 4 is also written as sin of pi by 2 plus pi by 4. And this is equal to cos pi by 4, that is also equal to 1 by root 2. Put n is equal to 4, d4 is equal to sin pi. Sin pi means 0. And put is n is equal to 5, d5 is equal to sin pi by 4, that is sin pi plus pi by 4. That means sin pi by 4, minus sin pi by 4, that is equal to minus 1 by root 2. Similar way we can find out the number of terms, but here we need only to find the only first five terms of the sequence. So this is enough for this sequence. Okay, the sequence dn is equal to 1 by root 2, 1, 1 by root 2, 0, minus 1 by root 2. Now, for each sequence below, determine whether it converges. If it converges, give its limit. No proof required. So, are you understand this problem? Only we need to find only the given sequences converges or not. If it converges, give its limit only. No proof required. Only this is also very easiest example to find out the answer. So here first problem, you can see the first problem here, Sn is equal to 1 by 3n plus 1. So to find the limit of the 1 by 3n plus 1, limit Sn is equal to limit of 1 by n into 3 plus 1 by n. So what I did here I take n common, okay, n is common from that sequence, that is limit Sn is equal to limit of 1 by n into 3 plus 1 by n. So limit n tends to infinity, the sequence also written as 1 by n by 3 plus 1 by n, that is, now apply limit 0 by 3 plus 0 is equal to what? 0 by something is also equal to 0. Therefore, the sequence has some finite limit, that means Sn is converges to 0 only. What about second example? Here take the observe the second example, that is Bn is equal to 3n plus 1 by 4n minus 1. Now apply limit n tends to infinity 3n plus 1 by 4n minus 1, and take the n common from numerator and denominator, this will becomes limit nn cancel, nn gets cancel, and limit n tends to infinity 3 plus 1 by n by 4 minus 1 by n. Now apply limit n tends to infinity 3 plus 0 by 4 minus 0 is equal to 3 by 4. Here second example also got some finite value. So the sequence has finite limit, then the sequence is called convergent sequence. If it has no finite limit, those type of sequences were called as divergent sequence. Here Bn is also converges, and Bn converges to what value? 3 by 4. And what about to third example, Cn? Cn is equal to n by 3 power n, and this is also this example is not convergent because infinity by infinity form, that means indeterminate forms can be rewritten as by using L'Hopital rule. Cn is equal to n by 3 power n, that is limit n tends to infinity Cn is equal to limit n tends to infinity n by 3 power n. Here apply limit infinity by infinity, that means indeterminate form. By using L'Hopital rule, you can evaluate this example. That means, what is the L'Hopital rule? If any sequence, either in the form of infinity by infinity or infinity power infinity, that means infinity by infinity means this is indeterminate form. These type of example we can evaluate by using L'Hopital rule only. So here L'Hopital rule means differentiate the numerator and denominator. That means here limit derivative of numerator n with respect to n, that is 1, derivative of 3 power n, that means that is in the form of a power n log a. In similar way, 3 power n can be written as 3 power n into log 3. That means simply we can simplify this problem, that is 1 by log 3 limit of 1 by 3 power n is equal to 1 by log 3 into 1 by infinity. The 1 by infinity means 0. 0 by something is 0. So here Cn is also converges to 0 only. What about Dn? Dn is equal to sin n pi by 4. So Dn does not converges because Dn has DNA has no particular finite value. It has sometimes for every n some form after Sn are equals to the 1 by root 2 and sometimes some Sn is equal to the minus 1 by root 2. Sometimes some Sn are equal to 0. Sometimes some Sn are equal to minus 1 and also equal to 1. Therefore, a DNA does not converges. Okay.